Okay, so now let us define what is idempotent element. What is the meaning of idempotent element? We will write down that first. And in the next part, we will show that a group will contain only one idempotent element. Okay, it cannot contain more than one idempotent element. So let us first write what is the definition of idempotent element. So if A, G is such that the square of that element means A square will be equal to again A. If such such thing happens, then I will say that this A is an idempotent element. What is A square? A square means A star A should be equal to A again. If such a thing happens, then this A is called as an idempotent element. Then A is idempotent. Now, as a guess, can we just simply make a guess that which element satisfies this property that A into A is again equal to A? Clearly, one thing comes in your mind is that E star E will be always equal to E. So, this clearly means that E is the idempotent element of the group, right? But this exercise in the next part tells us that we have to show that the group contains exactly one idempotent element. And who is that one idempotent element? We know that identity satisfies this property. Identity is already idempotent. So we have to show that identity is the only idempotent element. There is no other element which will satisfy this property. Who will satisfy this property? Only identity will satisfy property. So to show that identity is the only idempotent element. Okay? So, suppose I in the group, suppose I find the element A which is idempotent. Then what property will this A satisfy? A will satisfy A square is equal to A. Suppose A is idempotent. Right? Then what? Therefore, by definition of idempotent elements, this will mean that A square will be equal to A. Correct? And what is A square? A square means A star A is equal to A. Now this A, I can further write it as A star E. Means I will multiply that A like this. Because A star E is again A. Who is E? E is the identity of the group. Wo to group mein hona hi chahiye. That has to be in the group, right? So this means that A star A is equal to A star E. Now I see that this A and this A can go away by my left cancellation law. So by left cancellation law, this A and this A I can cancel, and what will I get is that A is equal to E. So this A that I was thinking was an idempotent element, actually after my calculation turns out to be that that A is nothing but equal to the identity. Means what have I proved in this part? I have proved that if suppose you find some element in the group who is idempotent, eventually that element turns up to be the identity element. So how many idempotent elements does a group have in that case? The group will have exactly one idempotent element. And who is that idempotent element? It is identity. So this finishes this exercise.